You are telling them and they are saying no. You are telling them and they are saying no. You are telling them and they are saying no. Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today, it's been a while I brought you things about building in general. Today, I'm on a site and I want to share with you what actually causes building collapses on construction sites, or even when you build and you are done with the building itself, sometimes it collapses, and whilst you are even in the process of building, some part of the building gets to collapse. And what actually causes all these things? Because there are so many factors that can cause this. So today I have about four different factors that I'm going to give you or share with you why your building has collapsed or will collapse if you do these things. So number one, I'm going to go with utilization of low skilled personnel. You know, people build, and many a times they use certain people that charge less. And sometimes I think what they do is they do some of their checks by asking the people or that personnel that or that artisan that what actually are some of your works, and perhaps the artisan will send them some pictures without they themselves having a strong proof that yes, they actually built these houses. And they give their houses to them, and at the end of the day they mess up and they are to go back and look for someone who will do this work really well for them and charge again. Listen, you are losing a lot of money. Like, you are, when you do that, you are losing a lot of money. I have met clients who are very, very stubborn. Trust me. You will tell them, this is not the right thing to do. Do this, do that, do that, do that. They will not listen. And for me, if you do that, I will leave your work for you. If you do that, I will leave your work for you. Because I don't see the reason why you have taken me as the professional to be advising you. And if I say this, you don't want to take it. If I say this, you don't want to take it. If I say this, you don't want to take it. Trust me, I will leave you. And if I charge and you think my price is so high and you can get someone to do it for you, fair enough. Because one thing that I always say is that this work, this is building. Like, you are building a house. This is not you buying a food, or you buying food, or you buying, this is a house, for God's sake. This is a house that you are building. It is something forever. So building with quality, like the quality personnel, the people who know what they are doing. It is one thing that you don't need to joke about it. Pay people to work for you. Do good works for you. That's one particular thing that I will tell you. And because at the end of the day, you will go back, they will do some shabby works for you, or even build to a certain extent and your building will collapse, and you are going to lose a lot of money. You are going to lose a lot of money. So when you come to us sometimes and we charge and we are giving you good artisans with so many experiences that we ourselves have witnessed, please allow us to work. My second point that I'm going to give you is using substandard materials. For me, you know, sometimes, as I said, it all boils down to some of the client, And also, some people that you have picked to look after this job or this work for you, they also do these stuffs. Using substandard materials on site. Using substandard materials. For example, it's iron rods. You know, iron rods, we have the mild steel and the high tensile. High tensile is the best. You understand? And someone will go in for the mild steel, they will use that one, and even going in for the mild steel, instead of them to buy the actual, let's say if it is 16 mm or 18 mm, they will not buy the 16 or the 18 mm, but rather buy a lower one. That's 14 instead of perhaps 16 or 18, or 16 instead of 18. Trust me, if you have someone who doesn't care about your project and you give them this opportunity, sometimes even when it comes to cement, the cements that we have in the market, for instance, we have the 42 and we have the 32. If you don't know the difference and you don't know what they are supposed to be used for, trust me, someone is, because the 32 is a bit lower when it comes to the price, so the person might decide to buy that one to do a concrete work for you. For example, your decking, and the person will buy 32 and even perhaps use half and even perhaps use half of cement to one wheelbarrow and two stones, bro. Please, we have standards, and it is very important you get your, you buy the right materials. It is very, very important you buy the right materials. Very, very important. Don't joke with it. This is, as I said again, this is a building. This is a building, something that you are putting up. This is a building. So please don't joke with this. Okay. My next point is going to be the type of land that you build on. You know, there are places that are perhaps, let's say, they are marshy areas. Some places too, the ground is a made-up ground. Perhaps you don't know, you went there to buy land and you did not do any soil testing or geotechnical test, and you just started building. And perhaps it's not even a residential home, but perhaps a public building. Trust me, you might be doing something that in the future you will regret. You might be doing so. That's why sometimes when you go in Ghana, for instance, when you go to the district assembly and you talk to them, they will tell you, if especially they do this especially for public buildings like hotels, hospitals, and story buildings, like 1-2 story buildings, they will tell you to do a soil test. That's a geotechnical report. You know, when you do that and you get to see the types of soil or the land that you are building on, the types of soil layers that you have there, if it is good for the structure, like you will be told. If it is not good to, you will be told. And perhaps the depth of the foundation, how deep it has to go, they will tell you all that, you understand, in the report. So it is very important you do a geotechnical report, or bring a geotechnical report, or you do a geotechnical report on the land that you are about to build on. It's very important. My next point is going to be, you have decided to build, yes, but you are not going according to the building regulations or the building standards. You see, if you are told that when it comes to decking or the reinforcement slab, You need to use, let's say, 1:1:1, for instance. That's one bag of cement, one sand of wheelbarrow, one wheelbarrow of stones, like for instance, then you would do something different. It is not advisable at all. It is not advisable, and I will never ever advise you to do that, because when you do that, at the end of the day, this video that I showed you, this is what is going to happen to you if you are not careful. And sometimes one thing that I will also say is that some of the clients, they are very stubborn, as I said earlier. They did the architecture design. The architectural design, it was, let's say, one story building, a ground floor and a first floor. And immediately when they are on site and they are building and they get to the first floor, and perhaps the client sees that, yes, I have, what's the name? I have money, so I can even continue this building or add another floor. They just do it. Some people can go as far as adding about 2-3 floors to the originally planned design that was supposed to be just one story. People do these things, and at the end of the day, structurally, you did not even prepare during the foundation, and you just decided to continue. Trust me, you are going to face this video that I showed you similar. So please, if you are a client, to make sure you do the right thing. If you know that some people, you will give pressure to some people, they will advise you, and perhaps for them, because they are taking money, they will not care, and they will do whatever you want them to do for you. At the end of the day, they will go away and this building can collapse. So please, try as much as possible not to force engineers or artisans to do this. A proper engineer will just walk away. If they see that you are doing something that they don't like and you still want to do it, they will just walk away. Yes, they will just walk away. So please, I will tell you, never do these things that I've mentioned in this video. Allow the professionals to work. Give them the materials and whatever that you are supposed to give them, give it to them so that they work. Please. Yes, because I have experiences, that's why I'm speaking this way. So please, but experience that I have is some clients can give you pressure. You are telling them and they are saying no. You are telling them and they are saying no. You are telling them and they are saying no. It's just crazy. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you.